and employers are demanding the labor, but who is supplying labor? Us, right? We are supplying the labor. So we are the employees, and employees are supplying the labor. So again, the price of labor goes on the vertical axis, and the quantity goes on the bottom, but the quantity in this case represents our work hours, amount of work hours we do, okay, as an employee, okay? That's the quantity of hours. And this is the upsloping labor supply. And basically, this upsloping labor supply reflects two effects, substitution effect and income effect. These two effects reflect this upsloping supply curve. So what's a substitution effect? There were a lot of management surveys in Silicon Valley, because in Silicon Valley we have Facebook, Google, all those apps, whatever. Now they have to really find very creative, innovative talents, right? So the companies have to think about what kind of incentives we have to give to the potential new employees so they can be attracted to my company, because they are stealing the talents from each other. Like Apple brings the talents from Google, or Google brings the talents from Apple, whatever. They try to steal the talents from each other. So they've been doing a lot of management surveys, and they found out once, let's say the college graduate young employee who makes, let's say, $80,000 in a year, this young guy actually prefers something else, not just the money, you know what I mean? Because let's say if he gets, let's say, $80,000 as a single person, you know, let's say he's happy with that, you know, the salary, then he is actually demanding some other incentives, okay? Such as maybe he wants maybe a free fitness benefit, maybe a free yoga, or more flexible hours of work at home, more telecommuting options. I mean, they look for something else. That's a substitution effect. Yeah, that's a substitution
like
effect.
Healthcare or something like that.
I mean, that is, well, that's, healthcare is a part of the benefit package. But the substitution in this case is, they're not just looking for just the money, but they're looking for, you know, some other non-monetary factors. That is the kind of substitution, you know?
Yeah. Oh
yeah, the profit sharing or something, you know, that is a kind of substitution, you know. So they are looking for, you know, people don't want to just work 40 hours, you know, forever. Some people just work, they want to work less hours. They want to work, let's say, 30 hours, you know, and have more free time, you know. So they can balance their, personal life and work, you know, yeah. They don't want to just work, you know, 70 hours in a week or something. Yeah. So the substitution effect, that's a substitution. The income effect is very relevant to the lot of these low-wage workers. For low-wage workers, they really need to make money, you know, the low-wage workers. They